In other cultures, all of them are dismissed as angels. But here, different quality beings have been identified as different types. You call for a particular being for a particular kind of benefit, so that you have an advantage of achieving things much more than you would do by your normal strength and capabilities. In this tradition, we have various kinds of beings. They are all particularly identified according to their quality. We have humans and of course the animal nature and all those things that you can see in around you. Those beings that you cannot see, there are some which we call as Bhuta Preta category. There are other beings that we call as Yakshas. There are other kinds of beings that we call as Gandharvas. And there are Devas. So based on this, there are tree gods, there are monkey gods, there are elephant gods, there is fruit god, there is vegetable god, there is flower god. For everything there is a god. Is this all figment of imagination? No, it is. Everything is happening because of certain forces. They identified these forces and personified them and created a method as to how to find access to them. So these yajnas were processes through which you can find access to certain forces in the existence, so that you have an advantage of achieving things much more than you would do by your normal strength and capabilities. The word yajna has been translated as sacrifice. So the English word sacrifice, you would always understand as giving up something for something else, or giving up something for nothing. That's a sacrifice, okay? Giving up something for something else is commerce. Giving up something for nothing is sacrifice. So yajna need not necessarily mean a sacrifice. Probably yajna is a combination of an offering, an oblation, and a sacrifice. It's a mixture of all these three things. A ritual through which you can please certain forces in the existence. In other cultures, generally they have not been properly identified and classified. All of them are dismissed as angels. But here, different quality beings have been identified as different types. And accordingly, you call for a particular being for a particular kind of benefit. There is a whole process and science behind it. Even today, people are using these yagas and yajnas. Generally, for a lot of them, it may not work because it's not being properly conducted the way it should be. But for many people, it does work. There are many, many people who are hugely benefited by these things. People do achieve what they want to do in the material world by using yagas and yajnas in a certain way. Even though it doesn't matter how educated they are and how much liberation they talk about, even today, 95% of the Indians, if they want to enter a new home, they will do yagas and yajnas before they get in. Only here at Isha we don't do anything because we are a different breed. If you are in a certain level of consciousness and energy, everything that you do is a yajna. You don't have to do a separate ritual. The very way you live is a yajna. So yajnas are of different kinds. Yajna means a certain means to access a dimension which is right now not in your access. One is a ritualistic yajna, that you perform something, an expert in the field comes and does something for you through which you receive some benefit, or you have made your very life process into your yajna. Thank you. you sit in the morning and you're doing your Shakti Chalana Kriya or your Shambhavi Mahamudra, this is an internal yajna. Without that sense of offering, you will never know the essence of that practice. If you make this a process, it's a very powerful yajna through which things happen in the world. Not just for yourself, things will happen around you beautifully. We have been saying constantly, if 1% of the world can become meditative, the remaining 99% will just pass very easily. Because if 1% of the world really begins to function, every moment of their life, their very life process is yajna, if they become like this, the 99% will reap the benefit without doing anything about it. 1% plants a mango tree, 100 people can eat it. 1% cannot eat what comes out of one tree. It takes 100 people to eat it. So similarly, if you have made your life process itself into a yajna, if you have made your life process itself into an offering, then thousands of people can eat out of it. You would see simple women, just they made their life into total sacrifice for people who live around them in their families. They just cook, they serve, they never thought about themselves. What about me? Never came to them. You see, they are sage-like by themselves. My mother was a living example like this. She was educated enough, but her whole life was just serving her husband and children, that's all. Never we heard her telling us, I love you. But such a question never arose. Whether she loves me or not, never arose in our minds. Because the very way she lives is in complete sacrifice for everybody around us. And nobody ever uttered anything about it, but in many ways, she was a goddess by herself. Everybody treated her as such. If she has to eat her morning breakfast, everybody in the family would have eaten. Then she will take a part of her breakfast and go to the backyard. She will look for ant hills, you know, nests of ants, and she will feed all the ants first, and then only she will eat. In today's mind, people may think, feeding ants, what nonsense. Spray insecticide, isn't it? She, if it came into the house, if it bit her children, she also did that. But somewhere in her mind, she felt the ants have as much right to live on this planet as she had. And just that little offering, everything is a sacrifice, everything is a yajna.